Hello everyone, this is your host Sharmila and welcome back to my channel Sharmila's Kitchen. It's the most wonderful time of the year that reminds us to soak the dry foods and I love to do it every year. Today I'm back with another episode on how to soak dry foods in chai and rum to make the best rich plum cake. First, let's make the liquor tea. In a saucepan, add 1.5 cup of water. Let the water come to a boil. It will take only 2 minutes on high flame. When it is in a rolling boil, add in 2 teaspoon tea leaves. We need strong liquor to soak the dry fruits. So let it boil for another 1 minute. Then switch off the flame and allow to cool down. I will share the quantities of each dry fruits in the description box. But before that, just look at the gorgeous dry fruits. First, I have delicious fig and apricot. Then I have golden and black raisins. Golden raisins are also known as sultana. Then we have black currants, tutti frutti. Traditionally, it is not used in UK recipe, but it really goes well in the cake. It is nothing but candied raw papaya bits, mostly used in Indian baked recipes. It is available in different colors like red, green, yellow and orange. Today I have green and red color tutti frutti. Now I have dried plums. Before drying out, it is known as plum fruit and after drying out, it is called prunes. I remember that in my rum fruit and nut cake recipe, someone asked me where this plum in the plum cake. Thanks for making me realize that we should add plums to the plum cake. So guys, here it is. It's dark and sticky fruit but tastes really delicious. Then I have a mix of some other dry fruits like strawberry, cranberry, blueberry and gozi berry. Berries are delicious and rich in antioxidants. I just love to eat like that. Then I have more collection of dry fruits. As I said, this year's plum cake will be really really rich with fruits. Here I have a mix of candied dry fruits like mango, pineapple, kiwi and papaya. So in total I have used 15 types of dry fruits. There is no such rule that you have to add all these dry fruits. You can add any mix of dry fruits. If you don't have prunes or berries, just skip them and replace them with some other fruits. Like if you don't have prunes or berries, just skip them and replace them with other dry fruits that you have. You can add other types of dry fruits such as dates, dried dates, pomelo, candied peels, etc. Prunes, fig and apricot are big in size, so chop them up into bits because it's not a great experience to bite big chunky pieces of fruits. Apricots are hard to chop with a knife, so I am using a scissor to chop them easily. Now I am gonna mix them all together. Mixing the fruits, ensure equal distributions of each dry fruits. Don't add nuts to soak in this. Keep the nuts separately. Today I am gonna soak in two ways. One version will be with rum and another will be with black tea. So first let me show you how to soak in rum. You should definitely choose a glass jar or bowl to soak and make sure the glass jar is sterilized properly. That means wash with hot soapy water, rinse and then boil in hot water to make it free from bacteria. Then dry out completely. I am putting a mix of dry fruits in the sterilized jar. Spread evenly and then tap the bottle to settle the fruits. Make sure that there is at least a 1 inch empty space from the top so that fruits can emerge properly. Now pour in rum. I'm using Old Monk because it's the most popular brand. Instead of rum, you can also use brandy or wine. You can soak the dry fruits in rum from 15 days to 1 year. As much as you soak, the dry fruits will absorb the liquid and become plumpy. Now let's soak in liquor tea. The tea has already cooled down, so strain out the tea. Now put another batch of dry fruits mix in a glass jar. and now pour in the tea liquor. If you are using black tea steeped dry fruits, then soak them just for 7 days before making the cake. If you don't have so much time to soak, then do it just before one day. And if you want to soak instantly, then you can dip the dry fruits in hot black tea for 1 hour and it will be ready to use. You can use orange juice or grape juice as a substitute of black tea. The dry fruits will absorb the most of the liquid and become dry. Then pour in some more liquid and immerse the dry fruits completely. Shake after every 2 to 3 days to prevent settling and soak uniformly. So the dry fruits are soaked nicely. Let's enjoy the holiday spirit. Wait for another 15 days, then we will be making a rich Christmas plum cake. Till then, watch my other food cakes and Christmassy dessert recipes. Thank you, bye!